Hello, my name is Andrey Azarov, I am CTO of Anisoprint, and in this video we will talk about how to reinforce part with composite infill. Here is the part that I want to reinforce. It's a fixture plate which is used to fix a part on a milling machine. If you will reinforce perimeters of this part, you will have fibers going along the outer contour and along the inner holes, like this. But the holes won't be connected with the edges of the part with fiber. The holes will be surrounded only with plastic. So, to make the part stronger and stiffer, we will need to place the fiber not only along the contour, but also inside the part. This can be done if we will turn on Generate Reinforced Infills option. Traditional way to make a composite part like this is to make a laminated plate with different orientation of the fiber in each layer. To make such structure using Aura, we can choose solid infill. For solid infill, we can specify sequence of the fiber directions. For example, here we have 0, plus 60 and minus 60. Let's look at the slicing results. According to specified angles, in the first layer fiber will go along x-axis. On the second layer, the angle between fiber directions and x-axis will be 60 degrees. And in the third layer, it will be minus 60. For the next layer, it will be again 0, then plus 60, then minus 60, and so on. Now the fibers will be able to transfer the load from the holes to the edges of the part. But if we will look at the material consumptions, we will see that we will need more than 700 meters of fibers to make this part. That's a lot, and the part is going to be very expensive. To reduce the cost of the part and have it still much stronger than pure plastic part, we can switch from traditional solid laminated infill to lattice infill. In Aura, we have three types of lattice infills: isogrid, anisogrid, and rhombic grid. Let's start with isogrid. For each type of lattice infills, we should specify fill density in percent. We will use 20% for this part. Let's look at the slicing result. Isogrid infill is a triangular infill, which is formed by equilateral triangles. Structures like this are called quasi-isotropic, as the resulting material will have almost equal strength and stiffness in all directions in plane. This is a universal type of infill, which you can use if you don't know exactly how the loads are distributed on the part. If you know the loads directions, you can go to an isogrid infill. With this type of infill, you can choose the direction of lattice structure, it's called guide angle, and also you can choose angle between main ribs. For 20 degrees and 0 degrees guide angle, you will get a structure like this. For this structure, you will have much more stiffness and strength in horizontal direction than for isogrid infill of the same density. Of course, we will have less strength in vertical direction, but if you know that the load is mostly horizontal, it will make sense. The last type of infill is rhombic grid. For rhombic grid, we can choose angles of two ribs. And for 45 and 135 degrees, you'll get result like this. Here is the result for rhombic grid. This type of infill can be used in combination with perimeters and can be used when the part is subjected to shear, for example. Composite lattice structures like this are very effective as the fibers are laid along the ribs, and we fully use advantages of high longitudinal properties of composite materials. Another advantage of composite infill is that if you replace the plastic infill with a composite one, you can reduce the filling density several times without reducing the mechanical properties of the part. As a result, the part will be printed faster and the weight of the part will be smaller. If you have any questions, please write us on support@anisoprint.com. Thank you for your attention and bye.